Let's start with a round of applause. Good afternoon to each and everybody present in the room. I, Snehil, the CEO of this club, would like to welcome you for this 18th meeting of our club. Before we start, I would like to tell you the three basic rules that we follow before we start. First of all, I would request each and every member to kindly put their mobile phones on silent mode. I'll give you 5 seconds to do that. Secondly, moving in and moving out of the room is only allowed after an applause. And the third rule is that please refrain yourself from speaking on sex, politics and religion. With that, I would like to call upon this stage the president of this club, Toastmaster Ajitab.
Thank you, Toastmaster Snehil. Let's keep the big round of applause going for our... Good afternoon, all. Dear guests and all my fellow Toastmasters, I welcome you all for our 18th meeting of Toastmaster today and congratulate all of the members for getting in quite an, I would say, explosive motivational before. Only those people who have been in the meeting knows what we are talking about. So let's hope we drive things as we go. You see, all of you must have heard of the story of magic beans. I hope everyone recalls there was a boy, he got some magic beans and he planted them in his house, and the next day it grew into a very huge tower. He climbed up that tower and there was a giant, and that giant had a lot of food and a lot of money, and he came back with a lot of money with him, and he finally came down, finally he cut the tree. I'm just giving you the whole story in just a gif. So, and he lived his life happily ever after with all the money that he had got. So everyone in his life dreamed of some form of that magic beans. You know, that bag of $1 million lying somewhere in middle of road that someone will leave for you. And everyone expects that someday this form of magic beans will magically appear in your life, and from there onwards everything will be hunky-dory and you will live happily ever after. But in reality, that never happens. Every time you have to take an effort, make an effort. Whomever you are seeing on the top of, let it be organization, let it be leadership, let it be entrepreneurship, even your own organization, even at your own family, at your own personal level, whoever has achieved anything, they have done with bit of a talent, bit of attitude, bit of dedication, hard work. And these all, my friends, are those magic beans which can take you wherever you want. So with that thought, as a president of L&T KOLKATA Toastmasters Club, I bring this order in session, meeting session. So today, to continue further, I would like to invite our Toastmaster of the day. So who is TMOD, Toastmaster of the day today? He is a person who is still going on through his sweet honeymoon phase because he recently got married. And when I asked him that, who and how he feels that whether his time before his marriage was good or post his marriage was good, and his simple response was, life is fantastic after marriage, sir. Life is fantastic. So without further ado, let us call our Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Abhinash.
long years ago, there was a man very hard working. Yes, hard working to gather money without spending time with his family, friends, relatives, children. Suddenly, he thought of taking a break, and on that day, someone knocked his door. Guess who? Unwanted real friend, the death. Yes. And between them, the person started bargaining with the unwanted real friend. He asked for one day. Give me a day, I want to live my life. As usual, answer is no. The next time in the same day, he asked for 2 hours so that he can spend that 2 hours with his family, with his children. Again, the answer was no. And finally, the friend allowed him for 2 minutes only. And in that 2 minutes, he wrote, value your time, spend time with your family, do whatever you want to do. With this, I'm announcing the theme of the day, value your time. Okay. And ability of a personality developer, guess, she is none other than our general evaluator, Toastmaster Shreya. Welcoming Toastmaster Shreya.
Good afternoon, all of you.
Good afternoon.
Today I have some gift for you. I'll be giving each of you 86,400 rupees. And you can spend it in the way you want to, but I'll give you 1 day for that. You can't add your money to it. You have to spend that much only. And if you then spend, I'll take the remaining money back. So how will you spend it?
Shopping.
Shopping, okay. And?
Booking tickets to hometown.
Okay. And?
Vacations.
Credit cards. Yeah. And would you like to leave some money apart so that I can take that back?
No.
Yeah, she's really good. The thing is that we all get this 86,400, not in cash, but in seconds each day. Similarly, we need to understand that time is a very important resource, a very valuable one, but the most undervalued. And today, to take note of everything that is happening and to value our time, I'll give a tidbits of whatever is happening right from when the meeting started till the end of it. And to help me with it, I have 3 role players. To start with, I have the grammarian Pradeep.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Today, I would be the grammarian for this today's session. So as a grammarian, it is my responsibility to note the good usage of grammar, like good thoughts, quotes, and other things, and also note down the not so good usage of grammar. And also, I will take note of any improper language or languages used in the meeting. So I will make the report completely, and I will be submitting at the end. Apart from this, it is my responsibility to introduce to you all the word of the day. So today's word of the day is incessant. It is adjective and its meaning is continuous or non-stop. Generally, it is used in terms of unpleasant way. So I'll give you an example of using the word. The incessant noise from outside was a real distraction during the meeting. So this is just one example to use it of the word. So I encourage each speaker who is coming onto the podium to use the word of the day. And in appreciation, I request each one of you to do a round of applause if any speaker uses the word of the day. I'll also record the report usage of the words in this, and I'll submit my report and also. Thank you.
As I was coming here, I was late because my car had a problem. We similarly face similar problems when you're in the road, some breakers and everything, which hinders a smooth ride. Similarly, our counter will take note of the speed breakers we have in our speeches so that we have a smoother ride or a smoother speech in our next speeches. So Sandeep is our counter, will tell you more about it.
Hello, Toastmasters and guests. Today, as an R counter, my responsibility is to keep track of any filler words or sounds that you may use while speaking. Filler words are the words that may be used unnecessarily or inappropriately, like, you know, as well, and so on. While sounds that may use as fillers are and so on. I will also keep track of any long pause, which is not a part of your script. Along with that, I will also be counting the number of repeating words that you may be using, like I, you, and so on. Apart from that, today, I am also going to keep track of any false start. A false start is the thing when a speaker says a sentence and then restarts it, saying either the same thing or in a different way. Thank you.
Thank you. And my most important helper today is Toastmaster Smitasha, who will be keeping a track of the timings today. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Time is free, but it's priceless. I will be keeping your track of time when you speak. Very usually, we keep lost of our time when you are in a flow of speech. So it is my duty to keep track and keep you informed about the timing. For table topic speaker, the time limit is 1 to 2 minutes. So at 1 minute, I'll show green card. That means you have reached a minimum level, minimum time. Then after 30 seconds, I'll raise a yellow card. That means the speaker has reached a mean level. You need to wrap up very fast. Then at the end of the 2 minutes, I'll raise that red card. That means your time already finished. You need to wrap up within 30 seconds because we have 30 seconds grace period to cover your speech. And then for the speaker, generally we have 5 to 7 minutes of time where we raise green card on 5 minutes, yellow card on 6 minutes, and red card on 7 minutes. And I'll keep the card raised until it completed the speech. Then the individual evaluators time limit should be 2 to 3 minutes. So at 2 minutes, I'll raise the green card, and again 2 minutes 30 seconds, I'll raise the yellow card, and at 3 minutes, I'll raise the red card, and I'll keep it raising till the evaluation ends. Thank you, and I'll submit the report when general evaluator will ask me to do so.
Thank you so much. So to value our time more, I'll call upon our Toastmaster of the day. Toastmaster?
Avinash. Thank you, Toastmaster.
Moving forward, I'll just brief you the structure of the meeting. It has been decided. It has been divided into 3 parts. First is prepared speeches, then table topic, and third and the most is evaluation section. So there is only one prepared speech, and the evaluator of the prepared speech is the person who clicks everything in his first attempt. Toastmaster Sri Kumaran. I request Toastmaster Sri Kumaran to read out the speech objective of.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Today I will be evaluating Toastmaster Rahul Maheshwari and his pathway innovative planning, and he is on path level 2 and project 2. And his title is Quitting is Not Losing. So I wish all the best to our guests.
So a person who is pursuing his BCom, passionate about sports, dancing and public speaking. He is a member of Toastmaster Club, Toastmaster Kolkata Club. Welcoming Toastmaster Rahul.
Winners never quit, and quitters never lose, never win. We have all heard that if you refuse to give up, then success will soon kiss your feet. If you keep on trying hard, then one day you will achieve what you've always wanted to. I completely agree with the first part of this phrase. But does that mean that if I ever give up, I am never ever going to be a winner in my life? Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and dear quitters. Now you'll be thinking that why is he calling us a quitter? Well, I did that because I think that after today's speech, I can somewhat change your perception about quitting. And if you haven't quit something in your life yet, you will surely tell yourself that quitting isn't really that bad an idea after all. We talk of legends such as Jack Welch, Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, but don't we all know, men, who revolutionized the world with their innovativeness, passion and vision. But don't we all know that both Bill Gates and Steve Jobs quit their standard education to pursue their passion? Bill Gates quit studying at Harvard and Steve Jobs dropped out of Reed. They didn't find education motivating enough and so they quit. They were quitters, alright, but are they not winners? Jack Welch, the legendary CEO of GE, decided to quit multiple businesses in which his organization wasn't among the top three in the world. He quit multiple businesses. Today I'll be sharing something where less people know about me. But if I have to explain how quitting can be important, I will have to share this. About 3 years back, Cupid struck me with two of his arrows. I fell in love with two things, a girl and partying. Everything in my life started to revolve around being with her and partying with my friends. On many occasions, I gave up. On many occasions, I let go of my responsibilities towards my family and my career to be with them. On many occasions. But on November 2017, my father had to undergo a very serious surgery. A surgery that had to be successful, otherwise things could have been bad. Me, being the elder son, of course, had to take up a lot of responsibilities on my shoulders. We had to look after the business, the house, the mounting medical expenditures and whatnot. Luckily, I had my family elders who were there to provide every support during those harrowing times. But where were my magnificent friends and girlfriend? Well, they were busy partying and having fun, and not one of them came and stood by me during those times. They didn't even call or ping once to know about my situation. I was in the same group wherein they used to plan these parties and outings, but not even one of them came to me, spoke to me about my situation and helped me out, or even tried to know what my problems were or how I was facing with how I was dealing with it. Not one came to me. And this is when the realization dawned on me. I could see the amount of time I was draining on my friends who didn't even care. And I completely understood what's going wrong. I was devoting a lot of time towards my friend by letting go of my responsibilities and my career who didn't even care. On many occasions, I let go of my responsibilities towards my mother who needed me. I wasn't there when my little brother needed me. And this is when the realization dawned on me. I knew that I'm doing so many things for people who didn't even care what I was going through. And so, I decided that I have to quit being with these people. I realized what a blunder I had committed. And now it was about time that I put a full stop to this friendship and relationship I was in. Today, I'm in a completely different headspace. Never felt more happy about myself. Always doing things that make me career oriented or help me towards my career. And most importantly, today, my family is proud of me for the way I've turned things around. And this was all possible because I chose to quit being with those people. Ladies and gentlemen, if you think that something isn't going right, a situation is not going to change, or your office work, your work is making you unhappy, or you're stuck, no matter how hard you're trying, stop persisting and running towards failure every day. Stop being rigid on yourselves by saying that if you quit, you will be a loser. Realize, few things in life are not meant to work out. All you have to do is learn to identify those things and then choose new and better routes for yourself to explore. You may be a quitter for sure, but trust me, from my personal experience, I can guarantee you, you will not be a loser. Because quitting is not losing. What do you say, Mr. Toastmaster of the Day?
Really, it was a motivating speech by Toastmaster Rahul. Moving forward, welcoming our Toastmaster, Table Topic Master, person who is fitness freak, Toastmaster Sasi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Raghunath. Hello everyone and good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and beloved guests. Welcome to this fine chilling session of the day, Table Topics. before I proceed, let me brief you about the rules of this session. The speaker have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes, where they have to speak for at least 1 minute, and at most what they can speak up to is 2.5 minutes, that is including the grace period of 30 seconds. Well, apart from this, our guest and our beloved guest enjoy this special privilege of changing the topic once, if in case they are not comfortable with it. For our fellow members, they don't enjoy these kind of privileges. So my heartfelt condolences to them. But before I start, let me give you a few funny tricks which will help you to nail the table topics. Well, as soon as you come onto the stage, listen to the topic carefully, repeat it in your mind, and shake hand with the table topic master, and then move graciously to your audience. Well, what does that do? This does nothing but it kills your 15 second long time. If you are yet not done with this 15 seconds, then what you can do is you can start with the greetings and compliment, like thank you table topic master for giving me this wonderful opportunity, and the topic is so interesting no matter how boring the topic is, and things like that. So on and so forth. You can go on venting out yourself by the time you feel yourself to be comfortable on stage. You can keep doing and keep trying all these things. Once you are comfortable, what you can do? Any idea?
Say thank you.
So by saying story,
personal questions.
Yeah, a lot of those things. You can start venting out yourself on the topic. You can think what you can, whatever you can try to vent out yourself, you can do. So, without wasting much time, because this humming sound of this air condition is the incessant humming sound of this air condition, haunting me like anything. So, without wasting much time, let's get our hand dirty and let's move into the session of the day. So, let me see who is the first volunteer of the day, who is ready. Oh, it's so nice of you. Yes. Toastmaster Rahul. Yeah. So we have Toastmaster Rahul to showcase his valor to us. And this is what you are having, Rahul. You can try your luck. Time flies. Yeah. Toastmaster Rahul, time flies.
Me, along with all of y'all, do you know what is that one thing common between us, among us? That is how much we miss our school days. Personally, for me, my school days has been the best yet. I can't say college because in Bhavanipur, it's not really a college life. But my school days have been my best. The way we had to share our bond with our teachers, our friends, all that we used to do for our school, playing cricket, being dancing, organizing fest, all that thing. After that, preparing for our exams that used to occur twice every year. How much of hard work we used to put for those exams, and today we realize that wasn't even something, but our life was so good. We used to complain then as well, but our life was so much simpler then. Fast forward your life to today. How many things have changed? Your life is definitely not easy. You all being in the corporate world have several commitments, so many commitments that you'll have to fulfill on your daily basis. Me being a student, have to keep pace, stay at par with my institutions to stay at par, to be with my curriculum. And like that, time has flied. So, I want to say that there are situations when you think that life is being tough. But trust me, this situation in future, you are going to cherish that it wasn't as tough that we thought. So with that, I hand it over to you, to your top master.
Well, the other trick which I forgot to give you was do your homework about the theme of the day, because there are high chances that the topics in this table topic will resonate with the theme of the day. Having said this, I cannot assure you that all the topics are in close proximity with the topic theme of the day. But still, let's try your luck and let me see who is going to be the second volunteer. Anyone? You? Yeah, Surya, yeah. Please come. Big round of applause for our guest or permanent member.
That's still guest.
Guest Surya. Yeah.
Okay, I'll
let me read it. Time and tide waits for none. Toastmaster Surya, time and tide waits.
Do any work honestly. We cannot tell like that I am lucky now, I am not lucky now. But I think so, I have already mentioned in the speech. I am lucky after marriage.
Yes.
And that was the, I think so, and second time say when I, my second child born. That time I was lucky. And even though I can tell like that, when I got selected by a dream job in L&T, when I was in Mumbai, I was passing through the Powai campus. And even though I went for interview that time in the L&T Infotech, but I didn't get selected that time. But it was my dream job to join the L&T. And ultimately, I got selected in 2013. That was my last luck.
Thank you, Toastmasters. Thank you for reminding us that being a married guy is also something to cherish for and something to feel lucky about. For our bachelor friend, think about it. So now can I have the third self-nominator? Or else, yes, you, Toastmaster Ajitav. When you are 80 years old, what will matter to you the most? Toastmaster Ajitav. Shall I repeat it? When you are 80 years old, what will matter to you the most?
Thank you, yes. Toastmaster of the day, Shashi. Good afternoon all. A very big question has been thrown on me in my 80s. As of now, I had my own set of dreams for next coming 5 years, and now you want me to think of next probably another 40-45 years. So it's a bit difficult to think of, but yes, I have my priorities and my settings set in my mind, and I have decided that within this time, this is how my life will be. And in my 80s, I see myself relaxed, sitting by my own beach house. Probably Malibu is the place to be for me. Okay, there will be a stingray standing right outside, and only car enthusiasts will understand what I mean by that. And I always had a dream of owning an American muscle car. So I have that distant dream with a nice wooden house, with enjoying with my life, with my grandchildren as well as my lovely wife. So with the position of which is still open. So that is how I imagine myself. But at that moment, I also have some other reality checks. I want my life to be set in a fashion where money is not a consideration or it's not a troubling feature. For me, spending time with my friends or taking an opportunity to connect with them is not a point to worry or to think over. So how my life at my 80s would be, I believe me, my friends, I will look exactly the same when I will be 80, and I will have all the, what do you say, vigor to roam around the whole world, follow my passion, and at the same time not worry about anything, as even I don't do it today. Thank you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you for giving us so many options when we will be in our good old 80s. So our next self-nominator is Toastmaster Anubhav. Which activity makes you lose track of time, Toastmaster Anubhav? Which activity makes you lose track of time?
Which activity make you lose your track? Sometimes you know we think too much, but end of the day we don't take any action. We can tell it as procrastination. So my most of the time I take when I start thinking about future and not lamenting about my past. So most of the time when I think about my future, the first question comes in my mind, that is whether I am using my time, that present moment, judiciously or efficiently. But you know, it's a trap. The more you think, time will just pass by. And if you start thinking at the morning 7 o'clock, you'll see that 3 hours or 4 hours will pass with this process. So my humble request to all of you, enjoy your present moment, give little time to think and stick to that, and definitely you'll enjoy your life to the fullest. What do you think, Toastmasters?
Thank you, Toastmasters. Yes, this incessant beat of the tick-tock of this clock often makes us think the same way what you have told us. But we'll make sure that not to think for a while for future very much, rather to concentrate on present. We'll keep this one in our mind, Toastmaster Anubhav. So I have, can we do one more at least?
Yes.
Yes, Toastmaster Ravindra. Time spares none. Toastmaster Ravindra, time spares none.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, friends.
Good afternoon.
Time spares nobody. Whenever we think of challenges in our life, we think that the challenges have been bestowed upon us, and we blame many things. We blame fortune, we blame the conditions which have surrounded us, which are the reasons for the challenges which have come to us. But when I reflect to my life, and when I see whenever I have been put across these challenges, I have always found that the time when I was worried with these challenges, I have always found out some mechanism to deal with them, and they never lasted for long, and I have come over it. But it is my resilience which has helped me to outcast that time and come out of it. Challenges will be there, and time will test an individual about these challenges. It is individual's effort to deal with that challenge is what makes a person. Whenever we are faced with challenges, we need not worry about what has been bestowed upon us, but rather dig deep in ourselves, the inner strength which we possess as human being, and find out ways to deal with that challenge, and not blame time about it, because time is a constant. It has been there, it is there, and it will always remain. So we should not blame time about it, rather we should focus within ourselves to find out ways to deal with that challenge. What do you feel, Table Topic Master?
Thank you, Toastmaster, for liking us so much about time. So with this, I think I have come to a closure of this session. And so now I request TMOD of the day, Toastmaster Avinash, to take us forward.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sasi.
It was really a very good session, Toastmaster Sasi. Without any further delay, let us move forward to a very important section of the meeting, the evaluation section. For this, I welcome our general evaluator, Toastmaster Shreya.
So we had only one prepared speech session. For that, the evaluator is Toastmaster Sri Kamaran.
Sri Kumar.
Thank you.
Well, it is very difficult to evaluate such a wonderful speaker, Toastmaster Rahul. Let us give a big round of applause once again for his outstanding speech. Well, he started with a very good lesson good title, that Dear Quitters. Well, we also agree that we are also quit so many things in our life also. And he, from his life experience as well as prominent experience like Microsoft CEO and GE founders, that all quitters, all quit things are not at all bad. Some things will also lead us to life forward. And his voice modulation was outstanding. He started his speech with a very high pitch, and later on he slowly jumped into the topic. And his hand gestures were excellent. He was using all like this, and he was moving all around the stage. The stage occupancy is very good. And one more thing, he was not at all shy. He was very confident. He was showing very good gesture, and his eye contacts are very good. And it is really incessant to find fault in his speech. So, but you know, all the good speeches also have some kind of fault in their speech. And it is Mr. Rahul Maheshwari also had something. So to point out few, at one point of time you were talking to Mr. Table Master of the day. So you were continuously focusing on this guy. You know what happened? Such things made him uncomfortable. So you can always move around your eyes throughout the speech and throughout the audience. And one more thing, at one point you were a little bit stuck. I don't know, maybe you might have forgot what you were trying to say, but anyhow, you somehow came out of these things. And apart from that, your speech was outstanding, and it was a good lesson for us also. I hope all people will be happy to quit few things to achieve the greater heights. Thank you.
So a quitter, but winner, Toastmaster Rahul. We appreciate your usage of the stage, but I felt you moved a bit too much, which was a bit distracting for us. And also when you mentioned 3 years back, it was like this. So it should either it would have been 3 years back or 3 years back. Then when you talked about the incident that made you realize that the way you're spending your time, you are depriving the ones who matter. So that realization did not reflect on your face, on your voice modulation. It was somewhat emotional. And also when you said that your family was proud with you, you should have taken a pause and smiled so that we can also see the happiness seeing your parents proud of you. And also, it was a heavy topic. We all had quitted in some point of our life, and maybe we felt like a loser. So you could have included some humor in your speech to lighten the moment and also to reduce the heaviness of those 5 to 7 minutes. Otherwise, it was a really good speech. It was a new crowd for you. And you spoke. And for our evaluator, Kumaran, you must understand that when you're speaking, the person who is most attentive to you is the speaker. So when you're greeting everyone, you should say, good afternoon, all of you, especially Toastmaster Rahul in particular. And also, it shouldn't sound like it's only your views. At times, you can include phrases like, I'm sure the audience will agree with me that your take on the content was really good. So it will be like a evaluation as a whole. Otherwise, it was really good. But yes, at some points I thought you were hurrying. You spoke really fast. Otherwise, it was really So before I proceed further, I'll take the report of the timer, our counter, and the grammarian. Timer.
I would like to say sorry to TM Rahul, because when he started, initially, I was so engrossed to him, I forgot to start the timing. So after that, I started maybe after 10 seconds of delay. So I had grabbed the time 4 minutes 57 seconds for your speech, which is well in time. Then for table topic speeches, again for TM Rahul, forgot to start the after
when Sandeep, you have to walk on your own chairs when Rahul is coming.
So after 10 seconds I started the timing, when I locked the time 1 minute 20 seconds. Then TM Surya, whose time tied wait for none for him as well, so 1 minute 32 seconds. Lucky Shatendra, after marriage. So 1 minute 26 seconds time. TM Ajita, who does not want to go to his 80s, but still 1 minute 53 seconds he took. And then TM Anubhav, a great thinker, he took 1 minute 17 seconds. And TM Ravinder, who has conquered his Ori, so he has taken exactly 2 minutes. So all the speakers well in time.
Hello Toastmasters and guests, it was indeed a pleasure listening to you all carefully today. Now I am going to give you the feedback which of course is going to help you improve your speaking skills. I hope that you will keep on improving session by session. So here we go, starting with our TMOD Avinash. You had one repeat, two pauses, and one false start. Coming to our speaker Rahul, Toastmaster Rahul, there were three repeats, main, let go, time has, and two pauses, one during your speech and one while your table topic. Coming to our TTM Sasi, you had one false start, like you said, our guest and then our beloved guest, then two ahs, one and one pause. Coming to Surya, you said there were two ahs and one repeat. Coming to Satyendra, one ah, two sos, one but, one repeat, that was that, and one pause. Coming to Toastmaster Ajita, it was on the verge of being flawless except one short pause. Toastmaster Anubhav, congratulations, you were flawless. Coming to Toastmaster Ravinder, there were two repeats, with this and with that. Coming to Sri Kumaran, you were flawless. That's my report.
Thank you.
Yeah, good afternoon. So I am back with my report. So first thing first, I congratulate the speakers for using the word of the day. In total, there are total three usages. So big round of applause for the speakers. Especially, Table Topic Master Shashi Bhushan has used twice and Toastmaster Sri Kumaran has used once. Total three usages. Then coming to the list of say good thoughts or good quotes. So there were many today, especially from our Table Topic Master. So I'll just read upon few. Realization dawned upon me, winners never quit and quitters never win, quitting is not losing, resonating with theme of the day, time and tide wait for none, lamenting about past, time spares none, bestowed upon us. So these are some, I observed few good usages of the grammar and good thoughts. Now coming to the not so good usage of grammar, one general thing I observed is the confusion between the plural and singulars. Say for example, activity make is used by one speaker. Activity is a singular, so it should use activity makes. So such kind of things were there for many people. So I just use one example in general. Then his title is some X, Y is used. Basically it is not his title, is the title of the speech. So maybe his speech title is, that way the speaker should have introduced. Next, have a give up has been used by one speaker, it should be have to give up. And one more common mistake I observe many people do use, they say did not felt. So when you use the did or did not, you should use a singular V1 form, which is feel. So you should use as did not feel, not did not felt. This is one general mistake I observe many people doing. Then selected by dream job, it should be selected for dream job. And might have forgot, it should be might have forgotten, because when we have we have, it should be V3 form. So these are few mistakes I would say not so good uses of grammar, and this is my report for the day.
Thank you. Next I'll start with the table topic speakers, but before that, kudos to you for using humor.
But some of the suggestions that you have given, did you mean them or was it in humor?
No, I mean them also.
But it's not the right suggestions then. You're not there to kill time. We are not here to say about how to pass those 2 minutes.
No, for the starters, for the toddlers like us.
No. See, you can go off topic. That will give you a different level of satisfaction. Wow, I goofed it. Right? We are here to speak and others to hear. So it's not the right suggestion. And then no speaker can thank you for the topic. Okay, so it was not a very prudent suggestion that you can thank me for that. And this was your gesture most of the time. So this is, your hand should be free. This was showing that you want to hide something, maybe your tension, your nervousness, something. So your arm should be wider, okay, to show that you are comfortable. And when your president came, just before he was about to start, you said, do you want me to repeat the topic? It's not that way. When you call him, say, Toastmaster Ajitav, which activity make you lose your track of time? No, sorry, Ajitav, what? Yeah. When you are 80 years old, what do you value the most? When you are 80 years old, what would you value the most, Toastmaster Ajitav? Nothing more, nothing less. You are not supposed to ask whether I repeat or not. Otherwise, it was a great job done, and it didn't sound like a toddler. You're grown up. Thank you. Okay, now the table topic speaker, Toastmaster Rahul. Your topic was time flies. Again, you moved a lot, and you did not wish us. Maybe because you are coming to the podium for the second time, but you must wish. You started with a personal story and you connected with the audience also, like they have their corporate life and everything. So it was a good take on the topic, but you could have built on it a little more. Then came Guest Surya. Time and tide waits for none. Yeah, when he started, cheers, and you started applauding. It was not supposed to be done, because he has already started and speaking on a table topic is really nerve-wracking. So, and you are not supposed to repeat a topic. You need not mention the topic. And you could have started with a story on how you missed something as time passed by. Maybe you are thinking that I want to do this, do this, do this, and you had engaged yourself in something. And maybe when it was too late, you realized that time has passed and you can't do anything about it. So that would have brought more impact to your story. Then came Toastmaster Satyendra. Toastmaster Satyendra, when was the last time you felt lucky? You spoke about the various occasions in your life when you felt lucky, but we don't know how much or what was the feelings about your last time when you felt lucky. Like you could have elaborated on the period before you got the job and the feelings, the stresses after getting the job. So it would have been more on the topic. Okay, thank you. And then Toastmaster Ajitav. Well, it was a really nice take on the topic. You had all those explanations of the various things that you dream of. So the visuals and the imaginary actually brought us to that place. And but then reality took you, and like you mentioned everything, like we dream of all those things, but again like life is not a bed of roses, there are thrones attached and we need to take care of it. And there was humor also about the position of your wife being vacant, so it was a really nice take on that. Toastmaster Anubhav, okay. Which activity make you lose your track of time? Again, I'll request you, don't repeat the topic. And your hand gestures was like this, 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 or this, this, more of it, like a crush gesture. It should be like synchronized, the hand movement. And also, I think you went a bit off topic, because it was about enjoying the present and everything, but you did not mention of that thing that makes you lose track of your time. Maybe you enjoy doing this so much that you don't care what is happening around you. So that way you lose your time. And also, since you had time, you could have included some personal story or that. Table topics is not about preaching about the topic, but including some personal touch to it, so that we, whenever we hear those lines, we can recollect your take on that, or how you realize the essence of those phrases. Thank you. Then Toastmaster Ravinder, time spares none. You also had some restrictive movement like this. You have a nice structure, but this, maybe you could have opened a bit more. However, it was a wonderful take, and you started with a personal story that helped us connect, and you utilized the time. You took 2 minutes, so wonderful take on that. Thank you. And now starting with a sa. As I mentioned last day also, you need to take the theme of the day right from the beginning.
But in the last time we went to DLI, it was told that sa is not supposed to speak on the theme.
Yes, only TMOD is supposed to introduce then.
But maybe not mention. Just touch, not elaborate on it.
Not elaborate, just touch with the theme and then call it.
And also when you're introducing your president, you should have mentioned something more about him. So that when he comes to the stage, he feels good about himself. And coming to the president, sir, you did a wonderful job. You included a story, but if you'd have included a story, something related to the theme, it would have more impact. For more impact, otherwise it was a really good story. And one thing, you have a guest here. So I know all of you know him, but you could have asked him something so that we know there's a guest or something, or how you feel about being in a Toastmaster meeting, like those things. So he would have feel more accommodated in the space. So I've touched on all. Now the role players. You all did a wonderful job, but only timer, you might have missed those 10 seconds. Please don't mention. You need not be honest about it. You just add those 10 seconds to his speech or whatever, but you need not mention. Thank you. Thank you for the time.
Thank you, Toastmaster Shreya. I hope you have remembered my story. The last 2 minutes of your life. The person wrote 3 lines. Imagine you have that 2 minutes right now and what you want to write in that letter. With this, I'm welcoming our president to take it further.
Thank you. Well, this is what I call a time well spent. There was no incessant wastage anywhere. Everyone got a bit more serious about how the way they spend their time. I would take this opportunity to thank our guest Surya, that you came time from your busy schedule. My apology, because I made an assumption that you are already a member, and I believe half of the people have already started mentioning you as Toastmaster because they already believe you are a member. You should do something about that. But thank you very much. Apology for not introducing you from the beginning. And thank you very much, guests, especially Rahul and Shreya. You took your time and gave a very fantastic feedback to our team. Taking up from your story regarding that 86,400 rupees, I would like to share with a concluding thought what I have learned in time management from my own personal reading and understanding, wherein they have actually explained that time is actually money from which you take from a bank. It's not just limited to 86,400. What conclusion that I derive from it is that over a period of time, you have 24 hours, 8 hours, let's say, for sleep and resting, another 8 hours for working, and then the balance rest hours, you spend it on something for which you are meant to, like time with family, friends, for your own leisure, your personal activities or hobbies. But many a times I have seen, specifically in a corporate culture, people say that they are working more, they are debiting, or I would say they are spending more time on their work. You know what you are doing? You are actually scheduled of family time, health benefit time, or personal interest or hobby related time, and you are spending it on work. Do you know what happens? Everywhere, every time you take some time out from your general activity and you waste it. Because you might take time out from your sleep. Probably some people are taking time out from their work for their Facebook. So every time you take this kind of withdrawal from your time schedule, you have to pay back. And believe me, you have to pay back with an interest. If you are not focusing on your health right now, the next day you will have to pay a hefty interest in terms of a bad health. If you will not be giving your proper time to your professional life, you will be taking a big hit and giving an interest in terms of probably not a very fantastic career. Similarly, sleep, not a proper health, family, no proper relationship. So with this, I would like to conclude this meeting by giving a small thought that yes, time is valuable, time is money, so make your withdrawal very carefully. With this thought, I would like to thank everyone and close the session.